This week on Maker Update, gizmos and greeblies galore, a side saddle bicycle, t-shirt quilts, and SLA screen printing. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we keep you updated on all the cool stuff that makers are making. How y'all doing? I hope you're all keeping cool and staying creative and working on some fun projects. We've got another great show for you, so let's check out the project of the week. You have to check out this cyberpunk exoskeleton cosplay piece by Zhao Chan Feng. Not only does it look the part with the paint and the finish, the exposed elements and the lighting, but it's also filled with animatronic motion. Like the way these panels lift away to reveal this intricate mechanical motion, or this circular lightning generator. The first part of the video focuses on how she made this mechanical element, and for as wild and mesmerizing as it looks, it's actually kind of simple. She's building a sort of camshaft using these offset collars, and then connecting the linkages so they all move as the main shaft rotates. All of the motion is driven by this geared DC motor. Maybe it's a little more steampunk than cyberpunk, but it's certainly got a great look and should be fairly easy to replicate. The other thing I can't quite get over about this build is how freeform it is. I'm sure she made a ton of design sketches, but the construction looks like it's all EVA foam, metal rods, and foam core. Instead of waiting for parts to print, she's just carving them from foam and joining them together with glue. It looks like a super liberating way to work. Even the structure of the mechanical armature and these servo mounts are just more foam core and EVA foam. With a fresh coat of paint, some internal lighting, and an Arduino Uno to drive the servos, this prop is ready to wear. Unfortunately, we don't get any details on this arcing lightning detail, but I would hazard a guess that a barbecue igniter is probably handling the work here. This is a gorgeous build with a ton of great tips, and like so many of her videos, it's also a relaxing, satisfying watch. Time for more projects. What happens if you try and ride a hoverboard like it was a bicycle? That's the question that James Bruton is trying to answer by building this omni-wheel bicycle. The first step is to create these massive omni-wheels. The smaller wheels are made of a two-part 3D print of flexible TPU and rigid plastic. The hubs are then made from CNC cut plywood and some 3D printed parts. The bicycle frame is also made from plywood with some specific 3D printed moving parts. These parts are oversized and pretty chunky, and he's printed them using a 1.2 millimeter nozzle. That's great for printing large parts quickly and with a good amount of strength, but it's tough to get tight tolerances. To overcome that hurdle, he's printed these inserts with a smaller diameter nozzle, which helps the part get a good interface with these bearings. The frame pivots in two halves around this central axle, similar to the way a hoverboard does. Each wheel is driven by the hub motors from the hoverboard, and their output is directed by the orientation of a pair of IMUs. It's definitely a bizarre setup, since it's easier to get the bike to spin on its vertical axis or shift sideways than it is to get it to move forwards and backwards. There's still some stuff for James to figure out, but it's a cool project all the same. From Becky Stern, we have a video of how she made this massive t-shirt quilt with her mother. Chances are, in the back of your closet somewhere, you have a collection of old t-shirts that you're still not eager to get rid of, even though they no longer fit your style or your frame. A t-shirt quilt is a great way to preserve them as memorabilia, and you can either display them or just use them to keep you warm. Come for the cornucopia of sewing and quilting tips that only a mom can offer, but stay for the quilting tech. I was blown away by this massive quilting sewing machine, and apparently it can also perform some automated CNC functions. This is a fun video, and for me at least, exposed me to a whole world of unfamiliar tools and techniques. And finally, on Instructables, I found this single PCB smartwatch designed by Akash V44. I really have to appreciate how minimal this thing is. It's a single PCB populated with an ESP8266 that runs the software for the clock and manages some of its IoT functions. It also has a small LiPo battery, the I2C OLED display, and a few push buttons. Cutouts in the PCB also serve as anchors for the watch band. The smartwatch uses Blink so it can control various appliances and other hardware functions. It's a pretty stripped-to-the-bone concept of a smartwatch, but it should be fairly trivial to hack into your own functions. Time for some tips and tools. From MakerTales comes a helpful process for designing 3D parts that need to fit together with an existing object. Normally, this is the moment that most of us go reaching for our digital calipers. Instead, Jonathan reaches for his camera. By backing away from the part and zooming in, he's able to capture a fairly orthogonal view of the object. And then once he has one master dimension, everything else is designed to scale. I'll admit this all sounds a little bit loosey-goosey, but he makes a few sanity check measurements as he's going along, and it's shockingly precise. He's also doing all of his CAD work in Blender, and his channel has a ton of tips on how to use this free and open source software as a CAD powerhouse. From Wild Rose Builds, I got this tip on how to use an SLA 3D printer to do screen printing. By creating a mesh frame and saturating it with UV resin that you'd otherwise use for 3D printing, he was able to expose and cure the UV resin to the mesh using the printer's screen. You get to see his full iterative process, from originally trying to design and print the mesh in Fusion 360, to using mesh fabric like tulle as the screen medium, to finally using genuine screen printing mesh. It's probably not going to work for a full t-shirt design unless you had a very large printer, but for small logos and printed cards, this looks like a cool way to get some extra mileage out of your printer. From Retro Tech Journal comes this video about how to make a cheap 3D printed winder for stop motion animation. You might remember being introduced to these from a video from the Craftsman Steady Crafting, and then got disappointed by the price of these unique tools. This video shows you how to build your own out of 3D printed parts, some affordable hardware, and a cannibalized helping hands tool. Not only do you get a handy tool on the back end, but there's also a ton of great shopcraft tips peppered throughout this video, like how to machine small brass parts, or just the importance of giving yourself constraints when designing a project. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we've got the latest entry in the Great Search video series by Adafruit, where I learned about chip clips. Not those things you clip over a half-eaten bag of Doritos to keep them fresh, but these are interfaces you can clip over an IC that gives you easy access to all the interface pins for analysis and debugging. Lady Ada talks about all the different types of chip clips you can search for, the different pin pitches, sizes, and everything else you need to start clipping chips. All right, and that is gonna do it for this week's show. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, and hit subscribe so you won't miss the next one. As always, great big thanks to DigiKey and all their support in making this show possible, and to you for watching. Take care, we'll see you soon.